Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the OpenHAB 2 GPIO binding. The GPIO binding allows us to interact with the onboard GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi. When I say interact, I mean be able to turn the GPIO pins on and off, as well as read the status of the input on a GPIO pin. First up, let's go over the parts I'm going to use to demonstrate the GPIO binding. I'm going to use a white LED, 5-volt 4-channel relay board, momentary button, and a door sensor. For tools, we are just going to need female DuPont jumper cables. The links to all the materials, tools, and parts are over on my website. The link is in the description. To make this guide easier, I'm going to be using my testing Raspberry Pi, running a fresh installation of OpenHAB. I have a complete guide on my channel showing how to install and set up OpenHAB. The Raspberry Pi is sitting in a clear plastic enclosure with a built-in fan, which is cooling the heat sinks I have installed. I have a kit for the Raspberry Pi on my shop over at mksmarthouse.com/shop. Now take the components and connect them to the Raspberry Pi using the female DuPont jumper cables and according to this picture. If you have any questions on the wiring, ask it down in the comments below and I will try to answer it. Here's a clip of my wiring. Next, we have to set up the GPIO binding. I will not be doing two separate videos for Mac and PC because the only difference is the software you use to SSH. On Mac you use Terminal and on Windows you use PuTTY. To install the binding, go to your OpenHAB web interface and click on Paper UI. Then go to Add-ons. After that, click on Bindings and in the search, type in GPIO, and install the one that says GPIO binding. If you want to configure some other settings for the GPIO binding, you can go to the Configuration tab and then the Bindings subtab. After that, you can click the Configure button in the GPIO binding. Personally, I didn't touch any of the settings. The binding is installed, now let's use it. SSH into the Raspberry Pi using the program based on your operating system. I recommend having my website open so you can just copy and paste commands. For this guide, I'm going to assume that you have an items file and a sitemap file. If you do not, then check out my video where I cover the configuration files. Anyway, the first thing we are going to do is create the items in the items file. Type in sudo nano /etc/openhab2/items/home.items and press enter. You may need to type in the sudo password. Now type in this big code block on the screen or on my website. What we did is create the items that control as well as read the status of the various things we connected. Let me explain what each item does and what each part means. The first item is the one that controls the LED. The first part is the item type, and since this will turn the LED on and off, we will use the switch type. The next part is the item name, and I just called it LED. After that is the label text, and this is what shows up in the user interface. Again, I just wrote LED. The next part after that is the binding config. I assigned this item to GPIO21, because that is where I plugged it in on the Raspberry Pi. The next set of items are for the relay board, and since it is a 4-channel board, I created 4 items. Each item is almost the same except for the binding config. I'm going to show you a couple different ways you can configure this binding, but for this relay board, the item config you should be using for every channel is the one on channel 1. The first part of the binding config is the pin to connect to, and for this one, it is pin 26. The next part is the active low, which is set to yes. Active low means that when the switch is off, there will be no voltage applied to the GPIO pin, and when the switch is on, there will be voltage applied. After that is initial value, and what this does is tell OpenHAB what to set the initial value of the item during initialization. This one is set to high because I want the switch to be turned off during initialization. The next item is channel 2, and for this one I set active low to yes and an initial value to low. So this one will be like channel 1 except during initialization the switch will be on. The binding config for channel 3 and 4 are a little bit different because they do not have the initial value, so instead they will use the default value of high. Also, these two items have different values in active low. You will be able to see the different items work later when I show you a demo of everything. Next up is the GPIO pins that act as inputs. First is the door sensor, and since the door sensor has two states, open and closed, we will use contact for the item type. For the label text, I just wrote door sensor and format of input as %s. In the binding config, I mapped it to GPIO 16 and set debounce to 10. Debounce means the time it waits before reading the input on a pin in milliseconds. After that is again active low, and this is set to yes because the way the button works is it applies voltage which trips the pin to high. The button item is basically the same except it does not have a debounce parameter in the binding config. That is it for the items file. Now press Ctrl X, then Y and enter to save. Now we're going to put the items into the sitemap file, so type in sudo nano slash etc slash openhab2 slash sitemaps slash home.sitemap and press enter. Then paste the following into a bracket and press enter. All we did is import the items into the sitemap. To save, press Ctrl X, then Y and enter. Let's test everything out. Go to your web user interface and then basic UI. I'm going to do it on a tablet. Before we play at the buttons, let's take a look at the status of everything. The LED is off and so is its switch. Channel 1 is off, so is its switch. Channel 2 is on and so is its switch. Channel 3 is on and so is its switch. Channel 4 is on, but its switch is not on. Now let's look at the input devices. The button is not pressed and on the interface it says open, and the door sensor is closed and on the interface it is also closed. Alright, now let's play with everything. When I turn the LED switch on, the LED turns on. To determine whether a relay is on, just look at the LEDs on the relay board. When I turn on channel 1, the channel 1 relay turns on. When I turn off the channel 2 switch, the relay turns off. When I turn off channel 3, the relay turns off. But when I turn on channel 4, the relay turns off. Now let's test out the input devices. When I press the button, it goes to the closed state. And when I separate the door sensor contacts, it goes to the open state. That is it for the GPIO binding. If you need any of the parts shown in the video, you can buy a kit, the PCB, or 3D parts to make this device, as well as other devices, at the link in the video description. Alright, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to mksmarthouse.com/forum. Goodbye.